At 4:54 a.m. local time on August 7, 2024, an unexpected disaster occurred within Alaska's Kenai Fjords National Park. It was about an hour before sunrise when there was only a faint glow of the rising sun in the sky. All of a sudden, a distant but loud rumbling sound became audible, which continually got louder and louder. Seismic equipment soon picked up the sizable landslide that was occurring, involving an estimated 2 to 4.6 million cubic meters of unstable rock. Moving at a speed of 27 miles per hour or 43.6 kilometers per hour, it took 66 seconds for the fast-moving mass of material to reach the recently opened waters of the Upper Peterson Lagoon. Upon entering the water, the millions of tons of rock displaced it, generating a towering tsunami. This tsunami, across the next 72 seconds, raced across the Upper Peterson Lagoon at a speed of 108 miles per hour, wiping out as much as tens of thousands of trees in rapid succession and inundating more than a square kilometer of previously untouched landscape. Wave heights reached up to 56 feet or 17 meters above the shoreline, but as the tsunami wave continued to spread out at a broad and flat area between the two lagoons, it quickly lost its impressive height. As a result, when the wave struck the lower Peterson Lagoon, it only reached a modest height of 1 meter or 3.3 feet. Thankfully, no lives were lost due to this geologic event, although a local boardwalk, presumably although unconfirmed, to have belonged to a local group of structures was damaged. What had just occurred was Alaska's tallest tsunami to occur in 9 years, and the fourth such landslide-related tsunami to have struck Alaska in the last 100 years. While still not remotely comparable to the devastation that 1958 landslide in Latoya Bay, Alaska, which created the world's largest mega tsunami with a wave height of 1,720 feet, these events are truly becoming increasingly common across the colder stretches of the planet, and for good reason. So, why did this landslide occur? Just like Alaska's prior 2015 tsunami, which began in Tan Fjord, a retreating glacier was to blame. Since thorough record-keeping and mapping of this area began, the area's main glacier, known as Peterson Glacier, has been consistently retreating due to a global rise in temperatures since 1850. This has been occurring at an incredibly high rate, with a glacier having retreated an average of 260 feet a year since 1985. Thus, the vast majority of the Upper Peterson Lagoon did not even exist until a few years ago, as it was previously covered by a thick mass of glacial ice. This glacier had, while it remained at its full extent, held up a steep and inherently unstable section of cliff which prevented it from collapsing. With the glacier fully disappearing from the cliff in question in recent years, there was no longer a sufficient mass to hold up the cliff, so it slowly began to slide at a few decimeters a year. It simply took until 2024 for it to catastrophically collapse all at once. Similar events have recently occurred not only where glaciers have recently retreated, but also where permafrost has recently disappeared. This includes multiple other locations in Alaska, British Columbia, and Canada, and multiple locations in Greenland. More events will continue to occur in similar environments during the next several decades, so I strongly recommend governments to carry out surveys which look for these potentially deadly landslides while they are still slowly moving before they catastrophically collapse. An emphasis should first be placed on potential risk areas close to major population centers before going to areas which are less inhabited, then uninhabited, but sometimes used for work and recreation. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.